If you watch a lot of YouTube like me, then you may have come across this idea that the Hindu scriptures knew about the idea of the multiverse thousands of years ago, while modern science is only discovering it now. This idea is promoted by multiple creators, particularly BigBrainCo and the Ranveer Alabadi podcast, The Ranveer Show. In fact, the BigBrainCo thumbnail in bold letters says, "Multiverse is copied from Hinduism." So in this video, we're going to look at the idea of the multiverse, how modern physics arrives at this idea, and why these people are claiming that it was copied from Hinduism. Let's begin. The idea of the multiverse is so popular and mainstream that it has been used in the storylines of the most popular comic books of all time, DC and Marvel. And also it's recently been made popular by Marvel movies like Doctor Strange. It's the idea that many universes could exist parallel to our own. This sounds way too good to be true. So how does science arrive at this conclusion? Multiverse isn't any mainstream theory or scientific concept. It is a prediction of two models in physics that talk about this, the quantum mechanical model and the string theory model. Let's look at both of them and try to understand what they say. First, the quantum mechanical model. In quantum mechanics, we make predictions only for probabilities. Probabilities of the outcomes of certain events like the movement of an electron. The actual outcome we'll only know when we make an observation. To explain this, Erwin Schrödinger, one of the pioneers of quantum physics, proposed a very famous thought experiment known as the Schrödinger's cat. The hypothetical cat is sealed in a box with a device that has a 50% chance of killing the cat. According to quantum mechanics, the cat can be considered to be both alive and dead until the box is opened and the state of the cat is observed, and that'll tell us what the actual outcome is. The events or outcomes which you did not observe disappeared automatically because they didn't happen in reality. Okay, cool. So where does the multiverse come in all this? Well, according to one popular interpretation of quantum mechanics, all the possible outcomes do happen, not in this universe, but in a separate universe. The particle could have moved up in one, left in another, down in yet another. You get the idea. Each possible outcome is an opportunity for a multiverse theorist to come up with a separate universe out of nowhere. But there is a problem with this idea. Check this out.
Not only is the multiverse improbable, it's also a fantasy and fundamentally unscientific, as a theory can never be tested.
This video is a conversation between Roger Penrose, Sabina Hossenfelder, and Miju Kaku, three well-established physicists talking about the multiverse. You can watch it if you're interested. I'll leave the link down below. It gives you a clear understanding of why the multiverse idea itself is unscientific. Like, how do you test this idea? How do you observe something that doesn't happen? But because this idea allows anything to happen, it leaves a lot of room for creativity. And so it has driven the idea into the imaginations of people. And now it's relegated to the realm of fiction. Now, speaking of untestability, there are two leading theories in physics today, general relativity and quantum mechanics. But the problem is that these two ideas aren't consistent with each other. So in an effort to unify them, string theory was proposed. In string theory, basic particles are one-dimensional objects, small vibrating loops or strands. The typical size of a string is near the Planck length, or 10⁻¹⁵ meters, which is less than a billionth of a billionth of the size of an atomic nucleus. Now, these string theorists came up with a concept known as the string theory landscape. This landscape refers to the idea that there may be a large number of vacuum states or universes that the string could exist in, each with a different set of physical properties and physical laws. Now, I've oversimplified this a great deal over here. It's much more complex than this. If you want to dive deeper into this, I'll leave some links that you can read down below. The problem with this idea is that all the universes which apparently exist out there can't be observed. We can't interact with them in any possible meaningful way. So postulating that other universes may exist is unnecessary to explain what we observe. String theory itself has other problems. It doesn't have unanimous acceptance in the scientific community. It is, as of yet, untested, mainly because it has test conditions that can't be achieved easily. So any idea coming from string theory has no basis in evidence. And in some cases, it's as good as fiction. And speaking of fiction, there is a story in Hindu scripture that once Lord Brahma visited Sri Krishna and the Dwarpal, the guard, stopped him. Brahma asks the Dwarpal to inform Krishna of his arrival. When the Dwarpal does so, Krishna asks him which Brahma it is. The Dwarpal comes back and asks Brahma, who is now confused and a little pissed, and says that he is the four-headed Brahma and has come to see Krishna. Krishna lets him in and Brahma asks him why that insulting question was raised. Is there any other Brahma other than him? And Krishna says there are an infinite number of universes, each with its own creator, Lord Brahma, with a different number of heads. And he shows Brahma all this, and that's how the story goes. This is where all the interpretations of Hindu scripture talking about the multiverse comes from. Now, like I always say, there are some people who see this as a work of fiction and appreciate the imagination of the people who authored it. At the same time, there are those that take this literally and associate it with science to find parallels. It's like taking H.G. Wells' novel First Men on the Moon, published almost 70 years before the moon landing, and saying, hey, this book predicted people going to the moon. To these people, I want to ask, ever heard of science fiction or just fiction? Now, some people take offense to me using the word fiction to describe their mythology because they say that these books are historical because they talk about geographic locations that actually exist. That's like saying that the Harry Potter books mention the King's Cross Station, which is the real place in London, and saying that everything in those books, everything in the Harry Potter books is real. Magic is real. You see how absurd this logic is? Now let's assume for the sake of argument that I'm wrong, that Hindu scripture actually spoke about the multiverse. Even then, it's still unscientific, as I've already shown you with that talk featuring multiple physicists. The concept of a multiverse is untestable. It makes absolutely no difference to our lives or this reality that we experience. As always, Mr. Ranveer Alahbhatia and BigBrainCo are just misrepresenting science in front of their audience, just for the sake of appealing to their viewers' egos and thereby gaining some views. Content like this is expensive for me to make. If you did like this video, I'd really appreciate it if you support me on Patreon, Buy Me a Coffee, YouTube memberships, that thanks button, or by buying my merch or going to my website. The links are below. If you did like this video, you might also like this one I did on the concept of Vimanas, which are apparently ancient flying machines according to the influencers who try to push this idea. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, remember, science is dope.